Hello all you hardcore boxing fans out there, how are you doing? It's Big Porky here and we're at the Ponds 4 in Sheffield for the Dennis Hobson JJ Crump show. With me I've got Terry Chapandama from London, he does the New Age Podfather. Terry, what do you think about Oscar Amado against Tyrone Nurse, the fight that went on tonight? What do you think?
Well, when you're Tyrone Nurse and you've been up there already, you've been British level, you've done what you have to do. You know, we've seen the skills, we've seen the flair, we've seen the flash. Can he give us something new in his 30s? Can he give us something different? Can he get us excited again about Tyrone Nurse? You look at him, he's welterweight now, right?
40 odd fights.
43, is it 43 fights?
Something like that.
But worryingly only 7 stoppages. Yeah. But now you're looking at the guys that we want to put him in against. Conor Benn, Savage. He might not be the finished article, but mentally he's got that inner savage in him, which we love.
Yeah.
Then you've got Chris Congo, who he should have fought, and I'm disappointed that he didn't take that fight. Chris Congo, all the technique, all the skill, all the pedigree in the world. And you look across and you go, right, we want to see Tyrone Nurse mix it up there. Will O'Hara Davis move up for a Tyrone Nurse fight? They have previous. It's a fight that can be made. So he's in that mix, but the lack of power worries me. His skill's unbelievable, but what can you then do with that skill against those top level guys we want to see him against? You know, you as boxing fans should want to see Tyrone Nurse back, mainly because he's an interesting challenger to the guys we're all talking about at the moment. You know, we haven't even talked about Josh Kelly yet. Can you imagine a fight between those? It'd be like the Matrix. Angles, you know, rolls, slips. So he's put himself in a good position. You've got to give Dennis Hobson his due for this, right? Dennis has seen the potential, the opportunity. Now give Tyrone 3 or 4 fights, position him with a ranking, and then that's the right kind of noise to make. So good fight overall. I didn't expect him to stop the guy, but I did expect him to maybe, you know, show a bit more of a gap in class.
He won every round though, Terry, didn't he?
Yes, it was a 60-54 win. Which, as if you're a boxing fan, that's what you expect Tyrone Nurse to do. We just maybe wanted a bit more, take a few more risks. You're miles ahead of the guy. Just show us something different, but happy enough with the performance.
It's worked for him through his career, that sort of style, hasn't it?
Well, we've got to question whether it worked or not, because remember at 140, he kind of hit a ceiling. And that's why we've seen the comeback at 147. So we need, you know, he's trained by his dad. So let's see if they can try something different, because he's got all the talent in the world.
Do you think Dennis could pull a few rabbits out of hat for him and get him a title shot?
If ever a man could pull rabbits out of hat, it's Mr. Dennis Hobson.
Right. All right then. Well, moving on to John Chiwa against Super Tommy Frank.
Chiwa. Wow. Yeah. You know, whoever made that match, you know, took a hell of a gamble.
Late replacement though from Monday.
When you're touting someone like a Tommy Frank and you're mentioning names like Sonny Edwards and maybe even Charlie Edwards and those sorts of guys, and let's not forget someone like Prince Patel, when you're talking about Tommy Frank in that kind of company, we don't want to see him knocking over Lithuanian taxi drivers or, you know, Hungarian bakers. We don't want to see that. What we want to see is Tommy Frank being tested. And Chiwa today absolutely tested Tommy Frank. It's a fight worth watching, because I think Chiwa will fight here again. And he showed the kind of talent that if you're a promoter or a manager, you might scoop him up and say, we can get this guy a Commonwealth title. He looked like in the right environment he could excel. So I thought Tommy did well. Stay disciplined. One criticism only is Tommy tended to follow him a lot. Had he cut the ring off, I think the stoppage could have come a lot sooner.
What do you think of Tommy's support, the crowd that he had behind him?
Ponds Forge did fantastic numbers tonight. The noise for Tommy Frank was incredible. Another Dennis Hobson masterstroke, so credit where credit's due. You know, a lot of people said Dennis Hobson fell off. Ponds Forge Sheffield shows that he didn't. You know, what do you estimate? You estimate we probably did a take of about 70 to 100k here tonight. How many small hall promoters are doing that? Numbers don't lie. So all the outlets that want to hate on Dennis Hobson, look, the numbers don't lie.
Yeah, TV show. You think it was a good show overall?
It was an enjoyable show. Some interesting matchmaking. Some of the stuff off TV was really good. So, you know, when you see the European journeymen come over and perform out of their skin, it always gives you, you know, it's good. Now, there are some moments there where you're looking at some potential rounds of the year. on the small horse scene. You know, I thought Josh Whale, you know,
what do you think of Josh Whale against Eco Wilson? Big massive puncher, 16 KOs out, 19 wins.
What Josh did really well, and I think fans like to see this, is there's no feeling out, there's no trying to get confidence in the fight, there's no thinking it through, there's no overthinking, there's no over analysis. What you essentially have is that inner leopard, that ability to just strike, and once you've got your prey on the ropes, you just tear into that throat, pull it out, and that's exactly what Josh Whale did. He said, look, I'm back. British boxing, you thought I fell off, I came back. I'm here with Dennis Hobson, another guy people thought fell off. Everyone's back, we're all back, and this is what makes boxing fantastic, is the fact that there's always a chance at redemption. And so hopefully this is a platform, you know, people in South Yorkshire get behind your man. Dennis Hobson's your man, Josh Whale's your man, and it'll be interesting to see where he goes next. I imagine it's the IBF route.
Yeah, IBF,
but how do you navigate that intelligently?
Well, there's been talk about Gav McDonald next for him, Terry.
So Gav's, well, they're making the same leap up in weight, right?
Yeah.
And then Gav's following his brother up to 126 too.
Yeah.
So it'll be fascinating. Let's get everyone in. These guys live 20 minutes drive from each other.
Yeah.
It's like the school days, man. You know, we don't have to wait 2 or 3 years for them to fight.
Yeah.
Let them fight now.
Yeah.
Then let's resolve these issues. They know each other. Let's make everything happen. It's 2019. We demand these good fights.
Yeah. Do you think it's a good fight down line, lot, or do you think it should be made next?
Do it now. What are they going to gain by waiting? Nothing.
Yeah. All right. Well, thank you very much. Thank you to Frank, the cameraman, for coming over.
Yeah, but thank you to all you hardcore boxing fans out there.
All right then. Well, peace out. Keep on trucking. Keep supporting boxing.
Just keep trucking.